Hey, listen. I'm not the most sensitive guy in the world, but I can see that you got some kind of trouble, and you probably feel a lot better if you unload it on somebody. So if you want to talk about what's bothering you, go do it someplace else, okay?
Walter Matthau and Robin Williams as survivalists, finding it very difficult to survive each other in The Survivors, one of five new films we'll be reviewing this week on At the Movies, the movie review program. Across the aisle from me, Roger Ebert, film critic of the Chicago Sun-Times.
And across the aisle from me is Gene Siskel, film critic of the Chicago Tribune. The summer movie season is still in full swing, and in addition to The Survivors, we'll also be reviewing The Gray Fox, about a stubborn old train robber, the re-release of the uncut version of The Ruling Class, Evil Dead, which is about death and corpses and evil, and now Gene starts with The Twilight Zone, the movie.
Most everyone over the age of 20 remembers with relish the marvelous TV adventures into time and space called The Twilight Zone. Very clever and very scary stuff they were. And so a bunch of young film directors in Hollywood have gotten together to film the ultimate tribute. Four 25-minute episodes, sort of. The directors are Joe Dante, John Landis, Steven Spielberg, and George Miller. And the biggest surprise is that the worst episode was directed by Steven Spielberg of E.T. fame. Here's a scene from that episode with Scatman Crothers playing sort of a magical cheerleader to some old people who want to become young at heart.
Maybe if we played Kick the Can, you'd get a little hold of that magic we all been missing.
Marvelous.
A little hold on youth.
Look, their bones are old and will break if they try to run. Their hearts are old, their lungs are old.
Oh, Miss Cox would never allow us to go out there and play, Mr. Bloom. It's against the rules.
Rules? Did rules ever stop a child?
No.
You gonna let rules stop you from the chance of being young again?
No. I don't think so.
You see, this old man still has a little magic left in him. And if you believe, I can promise to make you all feel like children again.
But
you're making promises they can't keep.
Mrs. Dempsey, I want to see you dance.
Oh, I'd love it.
And I want to see you climb, Mr. Weinstein.
Like a quetzal, I'll climb.
We'll break the rules.
What can they take away from us? We have already lost.
What are you thinking of playing, Mr. Bloom?
Tonight. Tonight. Tonight.
Well, he has a nice smile, but the scene is just too obvious for my taste. Now, the scariest episode is the last of the four, directed by George Miller of Mad Max fame. It tells a story of an airplane passenger deathly afraid of flying. Would you like that to be your in-flight movie, The Twilight Zone? Take another flight. That was John Lithgow, and he's terrific in this little story. The reason this section works the best of the four is that it, more than the others, I think, convinces us that we've really entered another world, which was the whole secret of the show. I also somewhat like the story about a woman traveler visiting a weird family full of human cartoon people, and the moral parable about racism that opens the film, it's okay. So, on balance, an okay movie, just barely okay.
I would say it's just barely not okay. I didn't like either one of the first two segments. Mm-hmm. John Landis's thing about racism, I thought, was very predictable.
Yeah,
I agree with you. Spielberg was the disappointing low point.
Amazing.
The two lesser-known directors, Joe Dante, who has that part where the traveler goes into the strange people in the roadside house.
That's kind of neat.
And then George Miller of The Road Warrior with the scene that we just saw. Those were good, but on the whole, I would say I couldn't recommend the movie.
Well, we both agree it's sort of 50-50 on the on the four segments. The thing that tips it over into positive for me is the opening thing with Dan Aykroyd, the introduction to the four segments. Dan Aykroyd and Albert Brooks, they're very funny, and they come back at the end just barely enough to make
a
recommendation.
Wouldn't you say with all the tradition of the Twilight Zone, they could have come up with four episodes, four strong ones instead of two?
That's I wish they had.
Next at the movies, Robin Williams and Walter Matthau join a paramilitary vigilante group.
Time out. You won't believe this, but I brought the wrong bullets.